Hello, and welcome to Unit 7. The topic of this unit is scaling in urban systems. This will be the last unit, the last full unit in the course, and it's a little bit shorter than usual. The reason for this is that the topics I'll be discussing are still very much areas of current and ongoing research. So there's not a final neat story that I can tell. Instead, I'll try to give a snapshot of some results and give my best sense of where things are now. And there are a bunch of papers and talks that you can dig into to learn more. So the central idea, the central questions behind urban scaling are similar to those of metabolic scaling. So for metabolic scaling, we asked, how does a system's metabolism change with its body mass? And we saw that that system, to a very good approximation, exhibits scaling, that the relationship is described by a power law with a 3/4 exponent, and then there's a nice mechanistic theory to explain why that power of 3/4 appears. So urban scaling starts with some similar questions. How do properties of a city vary as the population of the city changes? If I double the size of a city, what would I expect would happen to its GDP, or the number of patents filed per capita by city residents, or the total number of traffic lights or gas stations, or the total length of roads? So empirically, one sees that the data is more or less described by a power law. We'll see that the fits certainly aren't as clean as for metabolic systems, but there's some reasons that we wouldn't expect them to be as well. So I'll present first some empirical results suggesting or providing evidence that scaling occurs in cities. And we'll talk about maybe what's interesting about that and what that might mean. And then I'll say a little bit about some ideas for possible mechanisms or explanations for these power laws or power law-like behavior that we see. So let's get started by looking at some of the empirical evidence suggesting that there may be scaling in urban systems.